Mike Moore Media, the first place to hear Rockingham County news and information.
Our program is sponsored by Cone Health and today's Anypin Hospital. So advanced is so close to home, conehealth.com. Mayodan Town Council met last night. There was lengthy discussion on the town's golf cart ordinance and possible changes. Residents registered 13 golf carts last year and 2 so far this month. The new fiscal year started July 1st. Several issues on what streets golf carts can and cannot be driven. Setting up a different registration system using stickers that can be clearly visible to police. Town Manager Lisa Hopper said people are driving golf carts that have not been properly registered. The matter was tabled pending further study until the August meeting. Improvements continue at Ferris Memorial Park. There's interest in camping, and a feasibility study shows there's space to have 18 to 40 RV sites with room for more, but because of state health regulations, there may be issues with a septic system, the expense for one. The next steps, detailed site planning by a civil engineer and comprehensive soil analysis. Other park improvements, adding 5 miles to the mountain bike trail and expanding the disc golf area. Grayson Cardwell is working on an Eagle Scout project to place markers at exact locations on the popular bike trail that would be helpful to first responders in an emergency. Bill Lester, town engineer, is applying for an assessment grant to benefit water and sewer infrastructure, metering, record keeping, and inventory, among other things. It's $150,000, with the town contributing $15,000. In the public comments period, Gary Burke, who lives at 110 East Main Street, complained about a creek that flows through his property behind Dollar General. It's already washed away about 5 feet of land. He says the creek is on town property and it needs to be cleaned and maintained. Council voted unanimously to renew the contract for Hampton's Taxi Service, owned and operated by Michael and Annette Lilly since 1999. Rates are $8 in Mayodan Town limits and $1.85 per mile outside. One final item, Loy Grading and Tree Service of Reidsville will begin work soon on a concrete retaining wall behind Town Hall. Loy had the low bid, $6,500. Eden police report these arrests: Terry Lee Brown, 313 Monroe Street, driving while impaired. Matthew Talmadge Calouet, 190 Buttercup Road, felony possession of cocaine, possession of drug paraphernalia, Schedule 4 drugs, and open container of alcohol. Kelly Gail Jones, same address, felony possession of cocaine, possession of marijuana, drug paraphernalia, and Schedule 4. Charles Baring Roberts, 1030 East Stadium Drive, felony possession of cocaine and drug paraphernalia. Rockingham County 911 had 165 total calls overnight, mostly routine, except for a chase around midnight on Sandy Crossroad involving sheriff's deputies. The suspect was taken into custody. In banking news, Wells Fargo is preparing to eliminate tens of thousands of jobs to dramatically cut costs. More information is expected to be released after today's second quarter earnings report. The bank has been struggling with high legal and compliance costs related to a fake account scandal that broke in 2016. And that's the news for now. Annette and I were at her mother's in Mayodan yesterday. She'll be 92 next week. We were looking at her prepackaged medicines from Lane's Family Pharmacy. This is something new to all of us, but not to so many others. Lane's has been providing this MedSync service for many years. It's a great idea. Grandma is in her second week. Doses of her morning and evening medicines for 30 days are conveniently sealed, labeled, and delivered. It has so many benefits. You get exact medicines at exact times. It cuts down on confusion. That's very important for her. Prevents an accidental overdose. It's safer and easy to manage. We're really glad Grandma is doing this. Wish we had done it before now. Call Lane's Family Pharmacy, at 336-627-4600 and ask about and start you or a family member receiving prepackaged prescriptions. MedSync with Dispill, 336-627-4600. Delivery anywhere in Rockingham County from Lane's Family Pharmacy. Now, Rockingham County weather, sunny. High today, Wednesday, and Thursday, around 90. Friday and Saturday, a 40% chance of scattered showers, high 91 to 93. Sunday, mostly sunny, high 94. Can expect a heat index of around 100. Get current weather information anytime at MikeMoore.media, along with Rocking Cam, our live stream weather camera. That's sponsored by Heat and Air Controllers for year-round comfort, whatever the weather. Need a tow? Dave's Towing is a call away 24 hours a day at this number, 336-932-7478.
Quicken Loans presents the Sports Flash, driven by Jeep on Mike Moore Media. ESPN's Malika Andrews is inside the bubble in Orlando with the NBA. She reports that a pair of players, the Sacramento Kings' Rishon Holmes and the Rockets' Bruno Caboclo, have violated the league's bubble rules. What happens when such a violation occurs?
The way that these two did it was inadvertent. One just left their room during quarantine and wasn't clear that that was against the rules, and the other was going to pick up a food delivery and just so happened to step outside of the lines of what is actually campus and safe and on lockdown.
Now that Washington's NFL team will get a new nickname, other teams are in the crosshairs. That includes the Cleveland Indians, the Kansas City Chiefs, and the Atlanta Braves. The Chicago Blackhawks have said they won't change their name because it represents Chief Blackhawk, an actual historical figure. The team's original founder was a member of the 86th Infantry Division, also known as the Blackhawk Division. Blue Emu promises no chill, no burn, no odor, just what you need to soothe tired muscles and joints. That's your Sports Blast, driven by Jeep. Chuck Sanders, Mike Moore Media.
Hi, this is Jay Farner, CEO of Rocket Mortgage. Making the right financial decisions has never been more important. We can help guide you to those right decisions now, when they matter most. Mortgage rates are near historic lows, so when you call 8338-ROCKET or visit us at rocketmortgage.com to start your refinance, you'll be well on your way to saving money every month. The rate today on our 30-year fixed-rate mortgage is 3.375%, APR 3.59%. Right now could be a great time for you to take some positive financial steps forward with a cash-out refinance from Rocket Mortgage, which could give you the boost that you're looking for. In addition, we may be able to help you refinance with little or no out-of-pocket costs. At Rocket Mortgage, we're committed to every client, every time, no exceptions, no excuses, giving you the best mortgage experience. Call us today at 8338-ROCKET or go to rocketmortgage.com to learn more.
Rates subject to change. Pay 1.875% fee to receive this discounted rate. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Mike Moore Media Podcast Preview. It's our monthly visit with David Myers, Mayor of Madison. You can hear that this morning around 10 o'clock on all of our social media platforms. Now, today's Consumer Report.
Ford is reintroducing the Ford Bronco, updated for the SUV era. The rugged four-wheel drive vehicle was a popular staple of the 1980s and 90s. Brian Moody, executive editor at Auto Trader, says the redesigned Bronco will be a direct challenger to the Jeep Wrangler. Many small retailers are asking customers paying with cash to pay with exact change because of a national coin shortage. When retail stores and restaurants shut down for several weeks in March and April, economists say it caused a disruption in the normal supply chain of coins. The coronavirus continues to spread rapidly in many parts of the country, setting daily records for new cases. Scientists had predicted the threat from COVID-19 would decline in hot summer weather. They now conclude they were wrong because the population has not yet built up an adequate level of immunity. I'm Mark Huffman. Learn more at ConsumerAffairs.com.
It's National Mac and Cheese Day. Oh, that sounds good. National Tape Measure Day. Alvin Fellows of New Haven, Connecticut, was granted a patent for the tape measure July 14th, 1868. Oh, and this is very important. It's National Nude Day. Great idea on a hot summer day. The less clothes, the better. A nude, a little frightening for some of us, however. Today in history, 1789, the French Revolution began. 1914, Robert H. Goddard patented liquid rocket fuel. 1951, the first sports event to be shown in color on CBS TV, the Molly Pitcher Handicap at Oceanport, New Jersey. Tri-City Trivia, 1942, gasoline rationing began. Everyone got 3 to 6 gallons, and it had to last 5 weeks. 1949, O.W. Benson on Kemp Street had the first TV in town. It had a 10-inch screen. I bet he was popular. And on this day in 1989, a lot of us remember this, of course, Nan Doyle, owner of Nan's Hallmark Shop in Meadow Greens, was kidnapped and killed. Big name birthdays, Jane Lynch, 60, Scott Porter, 41, Patrick J. Kennedy, 53, Rosie Greer, 88, Anthony Evans, 42. In our music spotlight, how about some Elvis Presley? Here's a song that was released this week, July 13th to be exact, 1956.
You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please tell the phone. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said, please don't forget my past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't stop thinking of me. Don't make me feel this way. Come on over here and love me. You know what I want you to say. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. Why should we be apart? I really love you, baby. Cross my heart. Let's walk up to the preacher and let's say I do. Then you'll know you'll have me, and I know that I'll have you. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. I don't want no other love. Oh, baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. I don't want no other love. Oh, baby, it's just you I'm thinking of.
Ooh, that's Elvis from 1956. The year that started it all, Elvis had 5 number one hits in 1956. Wow. The same year for his first film, Love Me Tender. Of course, another number one song. A sad story in the news this week. Elvis and Priscilla's grandson, Benjamin, 27, has died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Well, that's our program for today. Let's finish with our motivational moment. A moment of patience in a moment of anger saves you 100 moments of regret. Make it a good Tuesday, friends, and remember to count your blessings.